Belonging. Everyone needs a place to belong, a place that fits you like your favorite pair of jeans, that's as welcoming as your much loved and much worn recliner at home. That's the way we're made. Not to be isolated, not to be alone, but to be together, experiencing life with others. And yet, Vance Packard calls America a nation of strangers, and studies show that 4 out of 10 people experience feelings of intense loneliness. Our American culture produces people who more closely identify with characters on weekly TV series than with their next door neighbors. Everywhere you look, there are signs that people are hungering for fellowship, community, and a sense of family. Every week, this sweet little old lady waited in line at the post office to buy 2 stamps. One day, as she got to the counter, the postal worker told her, "You know, you don't have to wait in line to buy stamps. You can get them from the machine over there in books of 20. The little old lady responded, "Yes, but the machine doesn't ask about my arthritis." People long to be connected. The Bible uses a lot of metaphors to describe church, but the most persistent is that of family. In the New Testament, believers call each other brothers and sisters, and in his letter to the church in Ephesus, Paul writes, "Now you are not foreigners or strangers any longer, but are citizens together with God's holy people. You belong to God's family." Maybe there's a pew in your home church worn in the shape of your bottom. Maybe you're as comfortable in your church family as you are in your favorite pajamas. On the other hand, maybe you've never felt like you really belong somewhere. Maybe you've never known the blessing of being a part of something as big as the family of God. Either way, I'd like to share with you something that Solomon once wrote about the benefits of belonging. 2 are better than 1, because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them falls down, one can help the other up. But pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. Also, if 2 lie down together, they will keep warm. But how can 1 keep warm alone? Though 1 may be overpowered, 2 can defend themselves.
First, belonging to a church family provides strength. Let me read that first verse again, which says, 2 people are better than 1 because they get more done working together. Solomon had discovered a principle that holds true for every epoch of time. None of us can do alone what all of us can do together. There is strength in numbers. In an old Peanuts cartoon, Lucy walked into the room and demanded that her brother Linus change TV channels. "What makes you think you can walk right in here and take over?" asked Linus. "These 5 fingers," said Lucy. "Individually, they're nothing. But when I curl them up like this into a single unit, they become a force to be reckoned with." "What channel do you want?" decided Linus. Turning away, he looked at his fingers and said, "Why can't you guys get organized like that?" That's the power of teamwork.
Furthermore, belonging to a church family provides support. Again, King Solomon put it in this way. 2 are better off than 1, because if one of them falls down, the other can help him up. But if someone is alone and falls, it's just too bad because there's no one to help him. Do you know what it's like to get knocked down? Of course you do. We all have troubles, don't we? It reminds me of an army chaplain who had a sign on his door that said, "If you have troubles, come in and tell me all about them. If you don't have troubles, come in and tell me how you do it." Calvin of Calvin and Hobbes' cartoon, Babe, gets dressed in his special clothes for school. He goes to school. He sits on some bubblegum, gets beat up by a bully, fails a test at school, and gets rained on the way home. At bedtime, he says, "You know, Hobbes, some days even my lucky rocket ship underpants don't help." We all have days like that, don't we? And Jesus promised us that he would. He said, "In this world, you will have trouble." But what did he say next? "But take heart, I have overcome the world." Jesus is all about helping people up, isn't he? When Peter tried walking on water and ended up sinking like a rock, Jesus reached out, took him by the hand, and helped him back to the boat. When a woman was caught in adultery and publicly humiliated for it, Jesus could have thrown the first stone. He could have kicked while she was down. But instead, he reached out his hand, lifted her up, and gave her a fresh start. That's what we're supposed to do for one another. Finally, belonging to a church family provides spiritual warmth. Two people are better off than one, for two people lying close together can keep each other warm. But how can one be warm alone? While this is practical advice for nomadic people living in the desert, it also serves as a spiritual metaphor. You don't have to live in a tent in the tundra to feel cold and alone. Anytime one of God's children gets separated from the family, our fire starts to go out and spirits grow cold. The Bible says, "And let us consider how to stir up one another to love and good works, not neglecting to meet together, as it is the habit of some, but encouraging one another." One of the most important reasons the church meets together every Sunday is to stir each other up.
A pastor went to visit a man who had been absent from church for some time. When the pastor arrived at the house of this wayward parishioner, he found him sitting by a fire of glowing coals. The man fully expected his pastor to rebuke him for his tardy attendance at services, but instead the pastor drew up a chair alongside the fireplace where the man was sitting, just peering into the fire. With the tongs, the pastor reached into the fire and took one of the red hot glowing coals and placed it by itself on the hearth. In no time at all, the coal began to lose its glow, and in a few minutes it was cold and black. The man looked up into the face of his pastor, who had said words as he said, and he said, "I'll be there next Sunday." He understood what Solomon was saying. The warmth you feel inside your chest as we worship together here today, that's your coals being stirred. That's your passion for Jesus, your love for God and for me, and for people being rekindled. When you first gave your heart to Jesus, he lit a fire in your soul. Belonging to a church family that you worship with and fellowship with fans of flames and keeps you spiritually warm.
Everyone needs a place where they belong, where people smile when you arrive and say, "See you soon," when you leave. Maybe your family is far away. Maybe you're feeling alone, or maybe you could just use a new friend or two. God doesn't just call us to believe, he calls us to belong. The entire Bible is the story of God building a family that will support, strengthen, and stir up stir one another up to love and good works for all eternity.